please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Welcome back. Today is turning out to be a bit of a macro day, though from the low point, there's been a bit of a buying as well, at least in this Nifty, Sensex as well. Bank Nifty, of course, is at the low point. We've been talking about crude-related plays. Actually, even ONGC and Oil India are of the high point. Now, I know this is not a new report, but we've been talking about this probability that if the oil, the under-recoveries continue and if everyone is sharing the burden, in that case, perhaps even ONGC and Oil India don't get away. So in that case, even there could be some burden on these companies as well. In the past, of course, they had moved out of that. But, the net realization on ONGC in the past has always been about $58 thereabout. So if you're moving to 70, I think even these companies will be asked to, I think, compensate a bit. But the stock on our radar right now is AU Small Finance Bank. They have raised interest rate on savings deposits. We have the management joining us. Sanjay Agarwal, MD and CEO of AU Small Finance Bank, is with us now. Sanjay, good morning. The rationale for raising the rates here?
Yeah, so, we have just completed our first year of operations, and we figured out that CASA is the cheapest source of fund, right? And CA won't come so easy, which is current account. So, and we have to give a value proposition to build our deposits. So we want this kind of customer who actually want to keep money around 1 to 10 lakh. So we have raised 0.5, and above 10 lakh, we have raised 6.75. So I think that gives very value proposition time to bank with us. And this will also allow bank to become more concurrent, more transition oriented, and also the cross-selling ability to those customers.
Okay. Good morning, Sanjay. What's the percentage of current and savings account that you currently have?
So
I think we'll have to reconnect. I think we have to reconnect with Sanjay Agarwal. The technology wasn't helping.
Some of the numbers that Abhishek had shared mentioned that about 31% is the current deposit base. It would be, I'm guessing, CASA all put together. I'm not sure if they're really targeting increase.
If you're paying 6.75, then there is not much of a difference between term and savings deposit. Actually, you're paying the same amount. But this is available only for large deposits. Mm. If you're a small depositor, I guess you continue to earn 4%.
So markets have had a bit of a rough ride to start off the day, though some of the stocks, as you can see on your screen as well, are off the lows. We are in conversation with Sanjay Agarwal, MD and CEO of AU Small Finance Bank. They have just increased the interest rates on deposits by about 25 to 50 basis points. Sanjay, what does this do to your cost of funds and margins?
Yeah, so as I told you that, this is a cheaper source of fund, and we want to raise money through this channel, which is CASA. And that also, first with saving account, because CA will take his own time in years to come, right? But we don't want to raise money through the FDs and the other deposits, which is more costlier. And this will allow us to raise money, in my opinion, more on a cheaper rates. So overall, I think the cost of fund will not get impacted, So in my opinion, on a year-on basis, I think our cost of fund will go down by maybe 20 basis points, 30 basis points as we grow this book.
Mm. What is your sense about margins more generally? Because you are also going to be on a branch expansion mode, plus you have this higher cost. So can overall operating margins also get hit this year, FY19?
So Lata, I think our distribution strategy is not that we want to open our branches more and more, because there are a lot of other options. We can go through BC, we can go through different channels nowadays, online, whatever, right? So I think we are not opening branches, just for the sake of that. But I think overall, that we can put this money on a higher rate of yield, on terms of our assets. So I don't believe that our margins will get skewed, this year also. Once our result will be out on maybe the weekend of 26th, you'll figure out that, our first year of ROEs and ROAs are intact, which we promised to the public in large. And I hope that the scale and the kind of the overall cost of fund, which will get, in our favor over the year, will help us to maintain our ROE and ROA.
Okay, and even the net interest margin, you had guided between 5.7 and 6.5.
Yeah, of course.
Even
yeah.
with this raising interest rates, you don't expect that.
Yeah, I, you know, Radha, this is just at 10% of our book, you know, overall on our deposits, right? Okay. Overall liability book.
You mean the total amount of deposits over 1 lakh or 1 lakh to 10 lakh is only 10% of your book?
No, I'm saying overall liability book. So deposit book is around 20%.
Sorry. Okay.
But overall liability book, you know, we have an AUM of around now 16,000 crores, right?
Okay.
So on that, 1700 crore is just 10%, right? Oh. So we want to increase this base, you know, we want to increase this share to maybe around 20% next year. So for that, it's a cheaper source. So I don't think that will be impacted on our NIM or, you know, NII. So, so that's the idea.
Okay. So cost of funds is fine. NIMs, you say, will be intact. Finally,
yes.
leave us with some targets in terms of the growth in the book itself for FY19. What kind of numbers are you expecting?
So it's so difficult to give you just now because we will make our whole budget in next couple of weeks. Mm-hmm. But I think we will have around this similar number because the second year of the operation of bank, you know, we don't promise that we'll do the bigger numbers in this year also. But I think the growth should be around 35-40% as we promised. Our NIM and NII will be intact. So I should take another 2 weeks to comment on this specific guidance.
Okay. What's the total amount of deposits as a percentage of your total liabilities?
So as of now, it's around 52%.
52?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, bond yields have risen, so maybe that will become a little costlier. And finally, you all brought down your troubled loans fairly significantly when you last reported. Will you be able to further reduce NPAs?
So I think we never had a troubled loan, honestly. So we are a retail bank. So
okay.
our NPA was around
3.08. You brought it down to 2.8.
Yeah. So I think this is the range which we will work upon,
okay.
you know, over the years.
Okay.
So I think the first quarter, second quarter always have some spike. But in third and fourth, as a retail operation happens, you know, the NPA goes down. So,
okay.
so I think we will work around these levels, and we are happy to be in this kind of range and bucket.
Fair enough. All right, we'll leave it at that. Thank you very much, Sanjay Agarwal, for joining us with your thoughts. So, from one small finance banker to one of the largest bankers of the country, a former chairman of State Bank of India joins us now, A.K. Purwar. Good morning, Mr. Purwar. Thank you very much for joining us. Well, we wanted your view as kind of an elder statesman of the banking sector, especially about the happenings in the private sector banks. Where would you put your finger? Is this somewhere where supposedly independent boards have failed?
Well, to be candid with you, the kind of working which has been found now in the respect of this institution, it raises lots of issues.
Mm.
Issues in the sense that, well, till the matter is thoroughly investigated, can we prejudge an issue and take a position that, well...
So you think the board was right?
No, I don't know really whether the board was right or wrong, whether the board was having adequate information to take a view whether the view is right or wrong.
So the other question is the interplay between the regulator and the board. Here the board had approved a reappointment for another 3 years. After a couple of months, the regulator felt that might not be in the best interest. And then we see a turnaround. So how do you view these developments about where the ultimate decisions are being taken and the fact that the regulator perhaps also needs to be comfortable with it?
Well, in the banking industry, it is very well known that all the appointments, all the extensions have to be approved by the regulators, mm-hmm. and regulators have to formally approve it. So regulator is very much within its rights to raise this question. But let me digress a bit. You know, as a banker, you said that, well, I'm one of the senior most bankers, largest bankers, so on and so forth. Perhaps as a retired banker of the State Bank of India, I'm concerned with what is happening. Punjab National Bank, it's put the entire public sector banking system on. And what has happened in ICICI, it's put a leading private sector bank. So what's happening in the banking industry? Banking industry operates on trust and confidence of the depositors, investors, and so on. And secondly, that these kinds of incident, what kind of impact it will have within the internal credit administration environment of the bank? I think these are two big challenges.
Yeah. Mm.
And industry has to work to restore the kind of trust and confidence which is there. And two, industry has to also ensure that the credit administration, which was there, where the people used to take decisions on credit on with professional integrity, and people there are a lot of honest people also.
Yes.
So they have to be encouraged to take decisions. It shouldn't happen that the decision makers simply shy away from taking any decisions whatsoever.
Yeah. Maybe we have to accept that the Punjab National Bank was a one branch problem. Uh-huh. We probably got blown away by the size of the loan,
yeah.
The 13,000 crore. But otherwise, it was two or three corrupt officials in one branch. Uh-huh. And I think now the government has gone with the microscope. Public sector bankers have gone with the microscope, and nothing has come to date in terms of LOUs in any other branch. So maybe we should allow that to rest as a one-off. Mr. Purwar, do you think we are paying, too much of... we are blaming bankers too much. Maybe the problem really lies in this country with even giving any corporate loan, whether it is State Bank of India or ICICI or Axis or PNB or the long list of PSU banks. The problem is not perhaps so much private and public as much as, corporate lending. Retail lending by private or public is doing well.
Yeah.
But corporate lending by both entities is a mess.
I would put it this way that, these lendings used to take place under a certain regulatory environment. Certain environment where certain instructions in respect of NPA provisioning, classification NPAs and so on, these were there. Now, if these provisions get changed, then system takes its own time to settle down. Mm. Now, if you don't give system the time to settle down and go on tweaking things, then it creates its own challenges and issues.
Sir, does it help if a chairman steps down pending inquiry? Mm. Are you in that camp? Does it help? Does it restore the trust and confidence
that
you said?
No, not at all. I'm not in that camp at all. I would like that, whosoever is there, in the interest of the institution, in interest of the individual, this must not be happening. This must not be allowed to happen.
Okay. So you still have faith in the large private sector banks? You still think that they will deliver after this?
I differ. I would only read that I have full faith on the Indian banking system,
okay,
whether it is public sector or
private sector.
Sector.